The Starship is shaping up to be the most powerful spacecraft ever built. Recently, its full height was demonstrated, when the two stages were stacked for the first time. However, during the flight of the Starship, the stages will have to come apart. The method for separating the two stages after liftoff is so simple, that it is mind-blowing, eliminating the complicated designs. Other rocket makers use SpaceX actually skipped. Using a separation mechanism, as incredible as that may sound. Join us as we explore the Starship's insane stage separation system. The Starship is made of two giant stages. The lower stage, or the rocket, which is also known as the Super Heavy, is the part that helps the Starship escape the Earth's gravitational pull, standing at in 70 meters. It dwarfs everything beside it. The rocket uses more than 30 sea-level Raptor engines to generate the liftoff force that is required. SpaceX has designed the rocket to be reusable, so after completing its job it will return to the Earth and land with the help of its four grid fins to prepare for the next mission launch. The spacefaring part is the ship, or the upper stage. This is another imposing structure, although it is about 20 meters shorter than the lower stage. However, it is heavier than the lower stage at the moment of separation. A fact that will come to play: the upper stage uses six Raptor engines, a mixture of the sea level and vacuum types, for propulsion and landing. It will journey to far distant places in the universe and return to Earth to land. Since it is completely reusable, just like the lower stage, Musk on his own part wants to use it to take people to Mars for a permanent human presence. On the planet, that will involve multiple trips to move tons of cargo for life support systems. Ahead of the explorers, he also has the more distant planet Jupiter in mind. As another possible destination, NASA also wants to use the Starship to lower its astronauts to the surface of the moon in its Project Artemis. The agency also plans to go to Mars in the Starship at a point, although it will be sending astronauts and not regular people. However, all these interplanetary trips will only happen after the ship has separated from the Super Heavy booster. Every rocket that delivers a payload to space ends up discharging the lower stage. This is in keeping with the laws of physics, because the dead weight of the empty fuel tank of the rocket will only hold the spacecraft back if it is not discarded the Starship. However, looking at the spacecraft standing so tall on its mount and looking solidly and seamlessly attached, you might wonder exactly how the two stages will come apart. When the time comes, other rocket makers take a more complicated and risky route in designing their own separation mechanism. More on that later, but not SpaceX, which is unbelievably skipping designing a separation mechanism, according to Musk, who is never afraid to share engineering details about his Starships. SpaceX is not adding anything new either to the upper or lower part. To achieve the separation, he revealed this startling detail during a three-part interview with YouTuber Everyday Astronaut. The spaceship will kickstart the separation process by using the gimballing Raptor engines on the Super Heavy to rotate itself. This is how the Starship will introduce angular momentum. Moments before the main engine cutoff, or MECO, during this period, the ship and Super Heavy will be opened, so that the two stages will drift apart due to the spinning motion it is undergoing. The ship will basically float away in a straight and stable line, because it is about 5 times heavier than the booster. At this point, this is where the 6 Raptor engines on the ship are fired up, after cold gas thrusters have been used to settle the propellant. Once the separation is completed, the liberated ship will embark on its voyage. At the same time, the Super Heavy will begin its flipping maneuver as it prepares to return to the Earth. This is the same process SpaceX has been using to deploy satellites from its Falcon rockets. It spins the upper stage and lets the spacecraft float away, courtesy of centripetal forces. Using this unusual method, SpaceX does not need to spend resources designing and developing a safer pusher spring mechanism that can push off a 1,300-ton spacecraft from the Super Heavy. The Starship is able to do this because of another design decision it has made on the ship. All the 6 Raptor engines are completely covered by a skirt, which protects the nozzles from being damaged due to the impact from the booster during the separation. SpaceX is notorious for trying to avoid as many complications in its designs as possible. When they can get away with it, the design team cuts out anything that is too intensive. For example, when the grid fins on the Super Heavy were revealed and their function described, many people might have wondered how the heavy components would be deployed and retracted and still maintain enough strength to push and drag a rocket weighing several hundred tons. However, SpaceX designed the grid fins on the Super Heavy to be deployed all the time, instead of having to design a complicated deployment and retraction system that will control the car-sized grid fins. that weighed tons, and due to the simplicity of the grid fins, it was easy to use them for another purpose entirely, that is catching the booster midair with the arms of the launch tower. This is keeping with Musk's principle to achieving success in any of his projects. He has 5 steps that he follows. Step 1, break down the project into requirements, and make the requirements less dumb, then attach the requirements to a person, not to a department. It does not matter who gave them to you, it's particularly dangerous. If a smart person gave you the requirements because you might not question them enough, you might take it as light gospel, like you have to do this thing, everyone's wrong. The process. One interesting fact about the Starship separation technique was that it was another SpaceX employee and not Musk that came up with a change in design. He or she was able to convince Musk to use the method. So if you've been seeing Musk as an authoritarian chief engineer that doesn't welcome ideas and always has his way, you will have to do a bit of reimagining of the illustrious entrepreneur. Because the opposite is the case. SpaceX is a place where ideas can flow both upward and downward. So how do other rockets separate from their spacecraft? Well, just like the Starship, all other rockets use some form of actuating latches or frangible bolts to hold the two stages together, or separate them during the separation. Some rockets, especially Russian rockets, use what is called hot staging, which involves the upper stage igniting its own engines, slightly before or at the same time. The coupling mechanism is opened, the ignited engines will blast the lower stage, below them downwards. In other rockets, the upper stage is separated from the lower stage a significant distance, before its own rockets fire off or goes off to space with smaller vernier thrusters. This separation stage is a source of additional risk for the mission launch, and is a very complex process. The more the number of stages, the more separations required, and the higher the risk of something going wrong. However, SpaceX is eliminating the risk altogether by using a simple separation process. In the Starship, we are getting ever closer to seeing this play out in reality, after completing test flights of the Super Heavy booster. The next milestone for SpaceX is the first orbital flight of the Starship stacked together. This is expected to take place before the end of the year, as SpaceX races to get its spacecraft ready. Starship will be the world's most powerful launch vehicle ever developed, with the ability to carry in excess of 100 metric tons to Earth orbit. Drawing on an extensive history of launch vehicle and engine development programs, SpaceX has been rapidly iterating on the design of Starship, with orbital flight targeted for 2020. Together, the Starship spacecraft and the Super Heavy rocket create a reusable transportation system that is capable of on-orbit refilling and leverages Mars' natural H2O and CO2 resources to refuel on the surface of Mars. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching, and goodbye.